The time has finally come. Midnight is out. I'm so excited. I can't believe it's here. So I have no idea what this is gonna sound like. I'm super excited. This is my first time doing a reaction on camera because usually I listen to albums by myself with my headphones on, zoned out, just like in the music. So this is gonna be fun and interesting and different for me.
First I did some Moonstone eye makeup.
Bejeweled my face.
Because track 9, Bejeweled, which I'm very excited to listen to.
And there are a couple stars.
My little moon earrings.
So cute. Okay, let's do this. First one, Lavender Haze. I'm so excited, okay. She says, I just want to stay in the lavender haze. So good. The 1950s shit they want from me. Is that what she said? I find it dizzying. I love that line. Asking if she's going to be a bride. And all she is a one night or a wife. Talking about 1950s shit. So she's talking about like gender roles and what the media and society is pushing her to be in her relationship. So when she did Behind the Song, she was talking about Lavender Haze and how she's in this love bubble and the weird rumors. And so I think that's obviously like what she's addressing here is the weird rumors of her getting engaged, not engaged, on and off. Things like that. Oh, I forgot to show you my Midnight's bracelet. Let me show you for a second.
It says Midnight's. This is from an Etsy shop called Say Like Yay. I chose to do every vinyl variant color except lavender. Lavender's not in there.
Keep going. If I do give a damn what people say, this should go for everyone. Don't care about what people say, just don't, because you're damned if you do give a damn about what people say. Great, amazing. Great way to start this album. Let's track two. Track twos have been bops in the past. Very excited to see what this track two holds for us. This one's called Maroon. I'm very excited to see how she uses maroon in this. Which definition if we're gonna do some color imagery in this. So I'm excited for that.
Just
whole part reminded me of Dress. The silence and patience pining and desperately waiting. My hands are shaking from holding back from you. It was just, it had that same sort of like tempo, but I'm gonna rewind it for a second. I just wanted to hear this bit. So, okay, so she is doing color imagery. It said Scarlet, Maroon, let me listen. The burgundy on my t-shirt when you splash your wine on me. The blood rushed into my cheek so scarlet it was maroon. The mark you saw on my collarbone, I think. The rust, I think she said the rust between two telephones. The lips I used to call home. So scarlet it was maroon. It's giving lipstick.
When the silence came, we were shaking, blind and hazy. How the hell did we lose sight?
When the silence, what did she say? When the silence came, we were shaking. It's giving me all of the silence and patience by
us again, sobbing with your head in your hands. Ain't that the way shit always ends?
Sobbing with your head in your hands, ain't that the way shit always ends? I don't know why, but the imagery of that was reminding me of All Too Well, the short film, when her and him, when they're like fighting. Remember? If you haven't seen it, Sadie Sink and Dylan O'Brien. they're fighting in like a living room. She's wearing like a white shirt. Anyway, that's what it reminded me of.
Just... You were standing hollow eyed in the hallway. Carnations you had thought were roses. That's us. The rubies that I gave up and I.
The rubies that I gave
lost you. No shoes.
Oh.
The dust.
There's something about Taylor Swift. Cursing. Let's listen to it again.
Over me, that's a real fucking legacy. Let me see.
Oh, her voice right there, so raw. That's my favorite part of this song. Great, amazing. I don't know how I'm supposed to rank these after this. Oh my goodness. The next track, I'm really excited to listen to track three because it's called Antihero. Taylor says that this is like a super personal, vulnerable song, one of her favorites that she's written. So I'm really excited to listen to it. This is also the first music video we're getting that's coming, in like 8 hours? So I'm really excited about that. And there's also going to be an anti-hero challenge.
I have this thing where I get older, but just never wiser. Midnights become my afternoons.
Midnights become my afternoons. I have no words. I think that line right now is really just resonating with me specifically. Just me. Thank you, Taylor. Thank you for writing this line for me. Midnights become my afternoon. It's time passing, right? It's time passing without realizing it. It's like at one point you're in the night and then the next you're in the afternoon. It's
my afternoons, when my depression works the graveyard shift, all of the people I've ghosted stand there in the room.
depression works the graveyard shift. The people, what did she say, ghosted, stand there in the room.
Graveyard shift, all of the people I've ghosted stand there in the room. I should not be left to my own devices. They come with prices and prices. I end up in places.
Beautiful. I loved that. But that was one of the lyrics that was revealed. Oh my gosh. Okay.
Places and vices, I end up in places. I wake up screaming from dreaming. One day I'll watch as you're leaving. Cause you got tired of my scheming. It's me. Exhausting, always rooting for the anti-hero.
I'm gonna check something. I think it was this one.
It's me.
Hi. It is. Did you hear that? This was from her Midnight's Mayhem with me, the first video. I remember thinking, that was interesting that she said it like that. That mastermind. She gave us the lyric.
It's me. Hi. I know that
I knew it. I knew it. We're on the hill. Relatable.
Too big to hang out, slowly lurching towards you. Some might disguise as altruism, like some kind of congressman.
Some kind of congressman.
I wake up screaming from dreaming. One day I'll watch as you leaving. Lose all its meaning. It's me. Hi, I'm the problem. It's me. And tea time. Everybody agrees. I'll stare directly at the sun, but never in the mirror. It must be exhausting. Always rooting for the anti-hero. Kills me for the money. She thinks I left them in the well. Dreams out.
Really hard not to cry on camera. It's like an upbeat song. Every time she said, it's me, hi, I'm the problem, it's me. You know, when you have all of these feelings, you know, about yourself, because your brain tells you all of these things about you, even when they're not true, and they tells you all the worst things about yourself, because I feel so much. I feel like a burden to people around me. So every single time she said, hi, it's me, hi, I'm the problem, it's me. And that's like what my brain tells me all the time. Like, it's just me again. I'm the problem. I'm always the problem. So thanks, Taylor Swift, for this song. Yeah, it's me. Hi. Okay.